Hey everyone, I'm here today taking a look at the Jurassic World Dominion Raw Striker Iguanodon from Mattel. Here's the packaging quickly, pretty standard Jurassic World Dominion packaging. And when you get this toy, the tail isn't attached, so you have to clip that on when you take it out of the packaging and then it's not removable. I've always really liked Iguanodon, so I'm glad we've finally got one in the line. For articulation, the back legs move forward and back like that. Front legs move forward and back and also out to the sides like that, and then there's some articulation at the top of the neck where the skull meets the head, and that'll go kind of up and forward like that. The articulation at the bottom of the neck is connected to the action feature, so it activates the sounds. And for the action feature, you basically just press the body down like that. And it presses down where it connects to the back legs there. Makes the neck go forward and that activates the sounds. The tail swivels at the back here as well. I think that's kind of pointless because it breaks up the sculpt. But that's just where the tail clips in. You can swivel it if you want to. I like the sculpting on the thighs there. There's a slightly different kind of scaling effect. You get that on the front legs on the side there as well. It's got a great head sculpt of all the detailing of the skull there, and the beak's painted, which is nice. And there's a great paint job at the back of these kind of creamy stripes with a bit of darker and lighter brown. There's actually quite a lot of colour shading with the paint job. More of that nice sort of brown shading effect on the back there, going up the back of the neck. Like I say, there's a couple of different shades of brown, like darker and a lighter brown, as well as those creamy stripes. The nails aren't painted, but it doesn't stand out. I don't think that's a problem. Sometimes it bothers me, but on this it doesn't. And you see the beak is painted, which I think looks really nice. And I just love the definition of the skull in the sculpt. Ever since I was a kid, I liked Iguanodon, but when I was little, they were always portrayed as standing kind of upright like that. All the pictures in the books I had the Iguanodon standing up on two legs like that, kind of like T-Rexes used to, and the thumbnail was on the inside sticking upwards, so completely inaccurate to what we understand now. There's a notch on the back there for the app code, so that means it does have a bit of a hole in the back. And there's the app code. This is definitely in my top herbivores, along with Parasaurolophus and Ankylosaurus. I've been hoping to get one of these for years in the line. I just want to thank Keep On Collecting for sponsoring me on Patreon. I'll put a link to their YouTube in the description. Thanks everyone for watching, and I'll catch you again soon.